I wanted to show you what I consider a masterpiece that Ralf will be taking over narration in a moment, but I wanted to mention to new people, new shooters, I know we have a lot of those on the channel, especially young people, they're the American Custom Gunmakers Guild. They turn out products like this all the time. Ralf is a member, and there are corresponding guilds in Germany, Austria, all over the place. You just don't hear about them on the news. They're not well advertised. But the people who know invest in these amazing rifles and shotguns and even pistols and have something worth owning, like lasting values. Anyway, this remarkable takedown, I was just admiring it, is really something else. And it, Ralf got a Negrini case, and Shark Industries put some foam to protect it. It's always a good idea to have something to store your rifles. I know a lot of collectors, and we tend to skimp on the cases. So this is an example of how to do it properly. Anyway, Ralf, please take over, and we'll learn all about it.
Yeah, for sure. Like, I just wanted to add something to the American Custom Gunmakers Guild. Like, it's an organization which is already quite old. I joined in 2000 as a, had to do two masterpieces, to get accepted, and they would judge it and they would vote on you and everything. So you just don't get in there that easy. And I had back then a Mauser actions, like I made a Kurz and a long one, like a extended one. So you actually needed three actions for that to do that. And a lot of work to do and got accepted. And later on, I got the title. I put another couple stocks down, and then I became the diploma too for a stock maker. So I'm like a metalsmith, member of the American Custom Gunmakers Guild, and as well as a stock maker. There's some other categories as well. But they hold their show every year first in Reno, Vegas, and then now at the convention in Dallas Safari Club show. They'll be in Atlanta next year, so they have their tables and everything, then exhibit their work. So, okay, let's get to this takedown. I just completed this project. That is a very intense project because very complicated to do takedown with two sets of barrels at the time up perfect, two sets of scopes and everything. Project originated from a customer in a really nice guy in Edmonton, Canada, but later on he decided not to continue with the project. So I found another customer in the US, and he took this project over. So it is a 9.3 by 64 Brennecker, the caliber, German caliber, very good, pretty powerful. And the other caliber he chose was the 280 Remington. So I'll show you this gun now, how to put this together. Like, this case is like, has a custom foam insert in it, so it, you can put it all in. And what I had to do, I had to send them cardboard templates with exactly the shape of the gun that they could manufacture this like that with the cutouts. So I'll show you the takedown here. It's it has, again, that Hagn action. This is a medium action with the takedown threads, which like an interrupted Acme thread, very coarse, like on a lace. And so it's very steep thread, very strong, and could never wear out. The action is beautifully engraved here in BC. Guy did that, very good engraver, Warren did that. And it is nitride, gas nitride hardened, so which is, it comes out like a charcoal gray, and you have to polish it and get silver underneath, but it's very hard on the surface, and it is very corrosion resistant also. So I'll put this gun together here a little bit. So we'll take the first set of barrels, and this is the 280 Remington. I actually have to switch it like this. So you see here, the threads, They're not all the way through, they're interrupted, just three parts. So you can just put it together like this, put it in, and it's very important for anybody who assembles, disassemble it, that the action isn't open, because if it's open, then that extractor sticks out. And if you would close it or so, it just wouldn't go in, that extractor's in the way. So the action has to be closed in order to assemble it or disassemble it. Never open, very important. And you do like this, now it gets tight. And this snapper here has to fit in the little cutout here. Now, I'll do it like this. I'll put the gun between my legs like this, hold it like this, and then I can take both hands, click it, push it over. Now it snaps in, now it's completely locked like this. If you want to take it apart, you push this button in the snapper system and turn it the other way, and I'll broke it loose, boom, apart. I'll put it together again and put the scopes on. As I said, this here is a 280, so I have to scope for the 280. And just to make it really simple, that you wouldn't mix anything up in a hurry, the caliber's engraved on here, 280 rambling on the scope ring there. I hope you can see it reasonable. That's a pivot mount here, a Recknagel pivot mount. And I just go like this, boom, and that's it. That's your gun put together like this. I can load it, shoot, safety on, off, boom. I open everything and then take it apart again. Just take the scope off here like this. Pretty slick setup, but to get everything perfect with the timing and all is a lot of work here. Yeah. The wood from the 280 fore end, because the fore end is split into two here with those plates. The wood is the original wood from this exact buttstock, so I had to find another piece of wood for the 9.3, which was very challenging, that the grain flow, everything matches this little piece of the fore end here. But I did pretty good, I would say. Yeah, here we go, it's together. Matched it up pretty decent for another piece of wood. Took a long time in the shop to look around for the perfect piece. With kind of a match like this.
Yeah, it looks so perfect.
Looks pretty good.
Yeah, I would say so.
Sometimes you see takedowns with different foreends where the foreend looks not even closely related. You know?
That's true.
Like to the, yeah, this one here is the same too. Like this. That's your gun here. Take it apart again. Yeah, so if you go traveling somewhere where you want to use it, you got a pretty flat shooting plains game caliber, and then a bigger banger for something bigger. Yeah. Here we go. That's kind of what it's all about, huh? See the side plates, here's a little cutout. Here's that snapper system, what works spring-loaded to click in to hold it. And all that does, just hold it that it doesn't rotate out. But they're tight, they're snug, that's why I put it here, to have the force and not damage anything. As I said before, the receiver is gas nitride hardened, so it's really hard, just surface hardened. And the threads are from a good barrel steel, so they're pretty tough, you know, but they're not really hard on the outside. So I did get the barrels black salt bass nitride hardened, and that makes them on the outside super tough. it's like hard, so they're like in the 70 Rockwells or so, but they're not through, so they would never break. I mean, they're very steep. So this system with this takedown, screwing it on, off, or whatever, I don't think you could ever wear it out or shoot this loose. I shot it already quite a bit, and there's absolutely no change in tightness of the assembly or disassembly. You can put a little drop of oil in it, or some molly grease, or a little bit on the barrel shank here, on the flat where it buttons up on the receiver, if it gets a little tighter, but it should function in any position, any circumstances. But it's basically, the takedown part is literally for travel. Once you go hunting with it or whatever, you probably leave it together until you put it back in the case. But it's such a nice short package. Two sets of barrels. You basically have two guns and two different calibers with two different scopes, higher power, lower power in one case like that. Pretty sweet little package for somebody, huh?
I traveled around a lot and, of course, saw many different rifles. Some I bought, some I didn't. One of the things that strikes me with this particular rifle is this takedown system, because you don't see takedown systems that frequently. Most of the time, they're pretty loose. So I thought maybe I'd ask Ralf to comment on the skill set and, you know, the concept of this interrupted thread and how to get it so perfect and durable. It's actually easy to make a takedown rifle that's rattling after a little while, but I think this will last indefinitely. Anyway, maybe you could comment on that, Ralf.
Yeah, well, that's basically like Martin Hagen's invention, that Hagen action and everything. And with those coarse Acme threads, that's been used before by other, you know, really famous gun makers too. They do this in a similar way with a snapper or other ways to lock it. But all this stuff is very difficult, has to be very precise and everything, and you have to have a lot of know-how. And to acquire that on your own would be very, very difficult. And I had the really fortunate thing when I was, like my background was out of the machining, tool and die making and machining, and a journeyman machinist, tool and die maker, and when I did gunsmithing then up in Fort St. John, and then when I tried to get in the Gunmakers Guild, I needed two references. And back then, Chris Weber put me on that. He's a member in Kelowna in the American Custom Gunmakers Guild, and his guy works for him, Steve Markin, partner. He's a stock maker. He's a member too. I needed one more reference, and then Chris told me, well, you should contact Martin Hagen. So I did that, and he came up with his wife, and they checked me out and everything, and then I ended up leaving Fort St. John and going down to Cranbrook to work with him. And really through all the years, like in 2000 on Canada that day, like 1st of July, we arrived here, and really at that time I went back to school in a way with Martin Hagen about the gun making, all this work, how he would work, what he would do, stocking. I never made a wood stock before. So the first stock I made for myself then in the shop, and all this stuff I know about this action and the fine shapes and lines and stock line, I learned that all from Martin Hagen. And
were many takedowns made?
He made quite a few takedowns, actually. Hagen's, and he did a lot of bolt actions, too. A lot of them, too. Like, he stocked for Hartmann and Weiss back then. When I was there, he did quite a production. It's a big job, all this stuff, this gun making. To that extent, to learn that, it's very helpful if you have a true master who can pass that down to you, yeah. And I would never know what I know now without Martin Hagen.
Remarkable workmanship everywhere. And if you take an interest in these custom guns, I know you know how to find the things you're interested in, but definitely I don't hear that American Custom Gunmakers Guild mentioned many places. So I thought, gotta get a video up and show, you know, what's possible out there. It does take time, by the way. They're but it's worth the wait, and then you really own something. Mm. All right, well, thanks for watching.